President Ma arrived here at about 10 o'clock Thursday night on board a China's Airways flight and received a presidential welcome. His courtesy call on St. Lucia's Prime Minister less than 24 hours later saw the signing of a joint communique between St. Lucia and Taiwan and a reaffirmation of the friendly relations between the two countries.
We hope to continue our cooperative projects well into the future. In my discussion with the Prime Minister, I also share with him Taiwan's development experience in economics and other areas. Also, we have mentioned the cooperative projects, for example, the basic infrastructure in St. Lucia, the prevention of banana black sigatoka disease, and also a very important medical program. In order to develop the human resources for St. Lucia, as well as providing scholarships, I also stressed in my conversation with the Prime Minister that we have launched a medical program to encourage St. Lucian students to study in our Yishou University. We hope you will continue to deepen and strengthen our education exchanges.
President Ma noted that Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony has spoken about the level of unemployment among young St. Lucians, and he expressed the hope that Taiwan can provide vocational training for young students with an interest in solar energy and other projects. This, as far as the Taiwanese leader is concerned, can help alleviate the local unemployment situation. For his part, St. Lucia's Prime Minister has made it clear that the island will welcome assistance from Taiwan, particularly in terms of private investment.
We believe that the Republic of China's Taiwan's considerable expertise in disaster risk reduction, sustainable energy and climate change, resilience and adaptation would be most welcome in St. Lucia and other Caribbean countries as we progress towards a sustainable development path. We are also pleased to note your country's continued support in the areas of agriculture, healthcare, community infrastructure, public sector modernization, and sport. The targeted interventions in community infrastructure in our communities are helping in reducing poverty and changing the quality of life of our people. We thank the government and people of the Republic of China, Taiwan, for their generosity.
Prime Minister Anthony says that St. Lucia is seeking to effect a change in its economic structure that will emphasize not only a degree of industrial activity, but will also substantially enhance the possibilities for the development of the tourism industry. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.